Welcome to the KNX tutorial series. First, let's talk about our automation website, where you can find equipment from most popular KNX brands. You can conveniently select the necessary KNX equipment and quickly calculate the offer on our website. Let's take a quick look at the history of the KNX protocol. The KNX protocol was created in 1990 by the 15 companies ABB, Gira, Simens, Schneider Electric, and other manufacturers. KNX is an open protocol. Each manufacturer can create their own devices, but must certify them with the KNX Association. The headquarters of the KNX Association is located in Belgium. The association strictly monitors compliance of new devices with the KNX standard. At the time of recording this video, the KNX Association already includes 500 equipment manufacturers, more than 94,000 certified specialists in 171 countries are KNX partners. At the moment, there are more than 8,000 certified KNX devices. Many certifying training centers, tutors, and integrator communities exist in the world. Data is transmitted via four physical transmission media in the KNX protocol. KNX-TP is a wired connection over a special twisted pair with a cross-section of 0.8 square millimeters. KNX-RF is a signal transmission by radio. Transmission is carried out at a frequency of 868 MHz. KNX-IP is the transmission of KNX data over the IP protocol. Most often, KNX-IP is used to connect serial KNX-TP installations, to connect system remotely, and to control the system via wireless Wi-Fi network. KNX-PL was used in early versions of the KNX protocol. Manufacturers no longer produce equipment that supports KNX-PL, and KNX-PL is no longer used anywhere. Let's take a look at the main advantages of KNX. Key benefits of KNX. First, a large range of KNX devices, more than 7,000 pieces of equipment, is the main advantage of the KNX protocol. There are KNX devices from different manufacturers, identical in technical specifications, but with different functions and logic. There are companies that have a full range of KNX equipment, from switches to DIN-rail devices, and there are manufacturers who deal only with equipment with a certain functionality. For example, Intesis produces only gateways for air conditioners, while Payroad produces devices for integrating voice assistant. Second big advantage of the KNX equipment is decentralized system. The decentralization of the KNX system means that there is no need for server or central controller that will issue commands to all devices. Each device works on its own. The decentralization of the KNX system means that there is no need for server or central controller that will issue commands to all devices. Each device works on its own. The advantage of decentralized system is that if one of the devices fails, the rest of the KNX devices will continue to work. It is always possible to replace or upgrade a necessary system component without affecting the functionality of the entire installation. Each device can be configured individually. Third, a major advantage of the decentralization of the KNX system is the ability to replace discontinued equipment with analog. But even with a lot of advantages, KNX has some disadvantages. Price. The cost of KNX equipment is higher than the cost of analogous of other automatization protocols. You will need the following components to get started: KNX bus power supply, IP or USB interface, and programming software. ETS5 license from the KNX Association, which also costs money. It is important to understand the scale of a smart home project. If you plan to control just a couple of lighting groups in a small installation, then choosing the KNX as your smart home automation protocol is very expensive and impractical. But if you are going to make a comprehensive automation of engineering systems and manage an entire house or apartment with area of 80 square meters, then the automation costs will pay off and will bring comfort and benefit. Basic functionality of KNX smart home installation. Lighting. Lighting control, both relay and dimming. Control of curtains, roller shutters, and various devices. Climate equipment. Management of heating, both water and electric. Ventilation. Exhaust fans, supply, and exhaust ventilation installations. Underfloor heating, both electrical and water. Air conditioning system. Direct control of indoor units of air conditioners. Also, indirectly, you can control security systems such as leakage protection system, video surveillance, motion sensors, fire alarms, intercom, entertainment and multimedia systems, multi-room, home cinema, and other media equipment. Now, let's take a quick look at the minimum configuration of one KNX bus segment. We'll talk more about this in the next video. KNX bus power supply, 30V DC, via KNX power supply unit, IP or USB interface for programming and remote control. IP interface is much more convenient than USB interface. The IP interface allows you to program and configure the KNX system via Wi-Fi from any convenient place and remotely configure the equipment in different rooms. USB interface also has a number of advantages. For example, you do not need to set a local Wi-Fi network at the facility and register IP addresses for programming KNX equipment. All you have to do is connect the USB interface to your laptop, and that's it. Up to 256 devices can be connected to one KNX line. The number of devices does not depend on the transmission medium, TP, RF, PL or IP. Bus devices can be various sensors, such as temperature sensors and buttons, actuators, such as dimmers and relays, as well as gateways and other KNX devices. The actual maximum number of devices will depend on the model of the power supply unit on the line. Basic rules for a KNX bus topology design. The line coupler is used to connect bus segments and lines. A segment is a set of KNX devices physically connected by a KNX bus. Each individual segment of the KNX bus must be powered by a power supply. It is worth choosing a KNX bus power supply with sufficient power to power the devices connected to the KNX bus segment. Each bus segment must be connected to other bus segments or a group of segments with a line coupler. KNX devices for the wired line, manufactured before the end of 2018, belongs to the TP64 technology. This means that no more than 64 devices could be connected to one wired line. To connect all 256 devices to one line, it was necessary to divide the line into four segments using line couplers. Since 2019, the regulations have changed and the internal resistance of the transceiver in KNX devices has been reduced. The new device type is called TP1256. The innovation allows you to use up to 256 devices per line without using line connectors. Both types of devices can be used in modern smart home system installation. Let's talk briefly about the supply voltage of the KNX bus. The voltage of the KNX bus is from 29 to 30 volts. In normal mode, although the standard allows components to operate at voltage of 21, the voltage drop can be a maximum of 9V. On average, one KNX device consumes 10 mA. The standard installation power supply for an installation of more than 32 devices has a capacity of 640 mA. However, you must understand that some devices may consume more than the standard 10 mA and you will have to install an additional power supply or drive the line into segments. Power supplies with the power of 160 and 320 mA are enough for small apartment projects where there are not so many KNX devices. Let's take a look at the topology of a typical installation layout. Important system devices are located on the main line. Additional lines can be connected to the main line using line connectors. Usually, additional lines are separate floors of a building with switches and floor control panels. We recommend using IP gateways to connect lines when scaling the system for very large facilities. Among other things, IP gateways serve as a link between KNX and dispatch system. Each KNX device has its own individual physical address on the bus. The KNX device address corresponds to the position of the device in the topology of the entire installation. This is the first parameter that should be assigned to the device. The physical address of a KNX device has the following format: number of the area to which the device belongs, number of the line or line segment on which the KNX device is located, device number. There can be up to 57,600 devices in one KNX installation. Primarily, the physical individual addresses is used to set up and commission the system. The wired KNX bus topology can have the following branching types. First, serial connection, bus. Second, star connection. Third, tree connection. All these options can be combined on any section of the line. The formation of loop topologies is strictly prohibited on any section of the bus. The transmission of commands over the bus is carried out using telegrams, which are transmitted to the destination address. Destination addresses are called group address. Multicast addresses have a specific data type and provide the communication between devices. From a system setup point of view, a group address is in a function in a KNX system. The group addresses have the format of three numbers separated by a slash: main group, slash middle group, slash subgroup. This address structure affects the priority of command transmission to the bus. For the most important broadcast commands, we recommend using the addresses 0/0/0 and values close to it. KNX devices have different form factor, functionality, and purpose. There are two main groups of devices. First, actuators, both ring rail and flush mounted, relay actuators, dimmers, gateways, and lighting control system, DELI 0.10V LED controllers, DMX. Actuators for controlling heating valves and heating elements, gateways for blocks of air conditioners, and ventilation systems, integration devices with the other bus protocols, such as Modbus, Crestron, Control 4, ATI. Data and visualization servers, integration devices with voice assistants, and much more. Second, user devices, such as switches, both keyboard and touch, various sensors, motion, presence, climate sensors, temperature, humidity, air quality, CO2, and many others. You can find a complete list of KNX devices and their functionality on our website. We collect the most popular and demanded equipment and also constantly upgrade the catalog for you. We'll put together a simple KNX installation, the serial devices, and demonstrate how everything works in the next video. Thanks for watching. Be sure to write the comments what you want to know about the automation and KNX. If this information was useful to you, we'll be glad if you support and press a like button on this video. This motivates us to shoot new educational videos for you. See you, friends!